Welcome to Opalesque Television. I'm in Bermuda and I just had the fortune to meet Mark Yusko. He is the CEO and Chief Executive Officer of Morgan Creek Capital. Mark, one of the terms that has come to real prevalence and importance in our industry is the term endowment model. What is your definition of the endowment model?
Yeah, Matthias, if you think about any large pool of institutional capital, an endowment, a pension, large family office, they have the same philosophy. You know, they want to preserve capital first, they want to grow capital second. I think the endowment model has really come to epitomize that approach of you're made wealthy by your alumni. The alumni give gifts to the university into the endowment. So your first goal has to be wealth preservation. And then you need to spend from that pool of capital. So you need a long-term, low volatility investment strategy that takes advantage of the four ways you can make money. Way number one, you can take credit risk. Way number two, you can take equity risk. Way number three, you can take illiquidity risk, private equity, private real estate, private energy, et cetera. And then you can use leverage. Most endowments aren't going to use leverage, so that takes that one off the table. So you're going to focus on those other three: stocks, bonds, hedge funds, private investments, real estate, commodities. By diversifying across all those asset classes, you lower the volatility, so you get the long-term return of equities, 7% real, 7% above inflation, which is what you need to cover spending, and then you do it with the lower volatility, so you get a greater wealth creation over time.
How has 2008 changed the endowment model?
You know, it's interesting. There's been a lot of discussion about, did the events of 2008 change the endowment model? Did it change the way endowments are going to approach investing? And actually, nothing could be further from the truth. If you look over the last decade, including 2008, 2009, and it was really fiscal 2009, because endowments operate on a fiscal year, June to June. Okay. So that fiscal year, they tied everybody else. You know, they did just as badly as the investors who had stocks and bonds. So people said, oh, it proves that the endowment model is broken. Well, if you outperformed for 10 years, so the endowments outperformed dramatically for 10 years by almost 1,000 basis points per year compounded for those top quartile endowments, the Yales, the Harvards, the Princetons, the Stanfords, the UNCs, the Notre Dames, and then you tie for 1 year. I make the joke that, you know, no wins, 10 losses in a tie. Only Ty Willingham aspires to that because he went 0-12 at Washington a number of years ago. So the idea that 1 year proves the model's broken doesn't make any sense. So how have we changed? How have endowments changed? I think what people realized is you're going to go through periods of time where mark-to-market has a bigger impact on your reported performance, but it doesn't actually mean that you lost money. So if you think about the three ways you could lose money, you could have it stolen. You could get Madoffed. You know, that didn't happen to the big endowments. They didn't have exposure to Madoff or other frauds. Once that money's stolen, it never comes back. Second way you lose money is you buy equity assets that disappear. Well, that didn't happen either. Most of the firms or most of the endowments had overweighted credit. They had looked at alternative strategies, hedge fund strategies. So they didn't lose money like Washington Mutual or Freddie and Fannie or AIG or those other things, GM and Chrysler, that went to zero. What really happened is they owned credit assets that got marked to market, or they had private equity assets that couldn't be marked up. And so there's this appearance of loss. But over time, if you hold those assets to maturity, they're going to mature at par if they're credit, or they're going to have big returns if they're private investments.
Mark, tell us what you do at Morgan Creek and what is it that an investor these days should really look out for?
Yeah, so Morgan Creek was formed in 2004. I came out of the University of North Carolina where I was the chief investment officer. I'd been at Notre Dame before that as the assistant chief investment officer. And we decided to bring the endowment model to other pools of capital, smaller institutions, families, people who couldn't afford to have a big team. We've got 22 investment professionals around the world. We've got offices in Beijing and Hong Kong and New York. So we do about 4,000 manager visits a year. And we focus on three things: asset allocation, manager selection, portfolio construction. Asset allocation by far the greatest focus, because that's where all the returns come from. If you think over the long term, 10 to 15% of returns come from security selection. So what most people spend most of their time on: should I own Ford or GM? The answer is you better be short both and long Tata Motors. Most of the returns come from asset allocation. Did I invest in gold or oil or real estate over the last decade instead of stocks and bonds? So by bringing that asset allocation focus to other investors, that's what Morgan Creek's really all about. So we advise clients, act as an outsourced investment office. We also run a big pooled vehicle that allows people to invest like an endowment fund for individuals. And then we run a series of hedge funds and private equity fund-of-funds that allow people to get access to different sections of asset allocation. We do manager selection. I said we do about 4,000 manager visits a year. We narrow that down. We invest with about 1% of the people we meet with. And then we do portfolio construction to build those portfolios that allow people to affect better asset allocations.